for your feature debate this evening, you guys. Your feature debate tonight, oh boy, is this going to be a weird one. It is veterans versus veterinarians, you guys. So if you're easily offended, you know where you are. Let's be honest, you guys. On the side of veterans, this guy also visiting us from Los Angeles, California. Good friend of the Arguments and Grievances Comedy Debate Show. It's our buddy Andy Sell. Put your hands together for Andy Sell. Oh, boy. Oh, man, looking a little different since the last time I saw him. I think something bad happened. And on the side of veterinarians, this guy, you've seen him on Animal Planet. He is a local icon around Denver. Please put your hands together for Dr. Kevin Fitzgerald, you guys. We got a real veterinarian on the side of veterinarians. All right, going first, Andy Sell.
Hi, guys. I feel like I made a bad choice now. I'm gonna confess. I was gonna do a character tonight. I'm not gonna do it because I feel like that would be disrespectful. I feel like if I did a character, it would be disrespectful to the brave men and women that give everything to serve and protect our country from tyranny and sometimes children. And wedding guests and challenging political discourse and really just any social sacrifice that might inconvenience us in any way. That's really, I don't want to be disrespectful to that. I will say, yeah, I get it, guys. I get it, you hippies. Okay, military-industrial complex. Fucking institutionalized economic marginalization and disenfranchisement. Blah, blah, blah. Do you get a discount at IHOP, motherfucker? No. No, because they don't give discounts at IHOP for whining. You fucking hippies. Military-industrial complex, yeah, okay, sure. But how about the veterinary-industrial complex? What about that evil empire, huh? Huh? I'm gonna talk to you guys about the problems with veterinarians for a minute, okay? Veterinarians, you know what they do? You know what part of their job is? You want to know something they do? These veterinarians, these selfless people, you know what they do? They cut open puppies. Okay, sometimes they gotta cut puppies open. And they put little kitty cats to sleep forever. And then they lie to kids about it. They're like, yeah, your pet's in heaven right now. They know there's no heaven. Veterinarians know there's no heaven because they know there's no God. Because what God would allow this world that has war and feline AIDS in it? They're lying. They cut open puppies, they put kitty cats asleep, and they lie to children. Let me ask yourself, what kind of person does that job appeal to? What kind of monster? Huh? 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 What kind of monster looks at that job description and says, hey, this looks like a pretty good gig for me? Best case scenario, they're just doing it for the money. Best case. Best case scenario, veterinarians, they're just soulless, cynical mercenaries. Just sacrificing any and all human emotion at the altar of filthy lucre. Blood money. That's the best case scenario. Worst case scenario, they like it. Oh my God, can you imagine? That's insane. I guarantee there's some of these sickos are getting boners while they do this stuff. It's terrible. Another thing about veterinarians, here's a fact. No gay ones. No gays allowed in veterinarians. They don't allow gay people to become veterinarians. What the fuck is that? The military got rid of that ban years, forever ago. Like, so long ago, I don't even know when it was. A long time ago they got rid of that. Catch the fuck up, veterinary medicine establishment. It's 2014. Who the fuck do you think you are? You fucking monsters. Come on. Let them... What? These gay people, they're good enough to go die for oil in a faraway desert because getting their brains blown out was the only way their shitty dad would fucking respect them? They're good enough to do that shit, but they're not good enough to stick a thermostat up a Shih Tzu's ass? Who the fuck do you think you are?
Let me look at you. It's like I thought. Man, you know, I don't even know what to say about veterans, you know. Just like you said, you know, what are you going to say? You can't make fun of them. But Barbie, I told Nathan Lund over there, I said, I don't know who's taller, but her ass is 6 inches higher than mine. And he said, I'm higher than either one of you. I don't know about veterans, but I know about being a veterinarian because I've been one for a long time. I was the veterinarian on the Ark with Noah. And did you know that Noah was a bad fisherman because he only had 2 worms? Did you ever hear about the flood, you little fucks? There were 2 of everything. It's a genius joke. Jesus Christ, what are these people? They got the poor gay guy sitting by himself. What the hell are they doing here? Veterinarians like jokes. They like jokes. You know, what has four legs and an arm? A pit bull. There you go. Kind of slow on the take. And then what do you get when you cross a pit bull and a collie? Still mauls you, but then it runs for help. And veterinarians are polite. I comb my hair before I go to bed to make a good impression on my pillow. Is this, can you hear any of these or see me? Veterinarians, we aren't known as great lovers. I had a blind date deal and I got her back to her place the other day. She said, tie me up and do what you do best. I tied her head to the bedboard and I neutered her beagle.
Wandering around. They let this kind of... This is who gets to be a veterinarian. Fucking Kris Kringle Crypt Keeper gets to be... All right. Look, my first round I spent talking shit about veterinarians, but now I spent that telling you why veterinarians are the worst. Now I'm going to tell you why veterans are the best. First, I'm just going to list a few cool veterans. Glenn Miller. Elvis fucking Presley. Heard of him? John McCain. Before 2006. Pretty cool guy. Pretty cool. Sergeant Slaughter. All right. Fucking Braveheart. That's a veteran, right? Luke Skywalker, veteran of the Star Wars. Conan O'Brien, veteran of the Late Night Wars. Bilbo Baggins, veteran of the Battle of 5 Armies, in theaters now. Silver Surfer, veteran of the Infinity Wars. Marijuana, veteran of the War on Drugs. Came out of that strong. Mexican Coke, veteran of the Cola Wars. Tupac, veteran of the War on Poverty so the police can bother me. Just some cool veterans. Also, I'm a cool veteran. I'm a veteran of the Battle of the Sexes. I literally gave my hand to marriage. But you know, women, you give them a hand, they take a whole arm. Am I right, fellas? That's just some cool veterans. I could go all day with cool veterans. You want to know what I can't go all day with? Cool veterinarians. The closest you get is that chick that wouldn't date John on the Garfield comics. It's the closest you get to a cool veterinarian. Not going to watch those motherfuckers on All Creatures Great and Small. Give me a break. Fucking British TV show. Okay. I had a whole bunch of stuff about English people there, and now it's gone. Vets have also given veterans, that is, not shitty vets, real vets, have given us some cool things. What? It was a joke. Get over it. I'm fine. Drugs. They gave us most of the cool drugs, like heroin, right? Golden Triangle. Anybody heard of it? How do you think we get heroin and opium in here without Vietnam vets? Didn't happen. Punk rock. Remember VFW halls? VFW halls? Fucking punk rock shows? That's the shit. Without veterans, there wouldn't have been any punk rock shows at VFW halls. This is the best time of my life, was listening to those punk... You ever tried to listen to fucking Bad Religion in a veterinarian's office? They kick you out. They throw you out. Also, I will say this. Veterans get PTSD, which is a really sad thing. It's a real thing that happens. It's a tragic thing. It shouldn't happen. You know who doesn't get PTSD? Veterinarians. Because they love what they do. Because they're fucking ghouls, man. They love animal torture. They're into it. A veteran has never put down... A veteran didn't put down butterscotch or mittens when you were 8 years old. Osama bin fucking Laden, you're welcome. Veterans did that shit. Veterinarians had nothing to do with it. Thanks, veterinarians. Where were you? Not American, you know what I mean? Hey, and I'll just say this before I go. I want to remind you that if you do decide to vote against veterans tonight, you want to know who else votes against veterans? Those fucking ding-dongs in Congress, am I right? Be better than those people. You vote for veterans, because if you don't, you're not American, and you support police brutality and homophobia, and you hate freedom.
Well, went to veterinary school in Fort Collins. If the guy sitting next to me would have applied himself, I would have done a lot better. I don't mean to tell you this, Andy, but in 35 years, you're going to look just like me. I made him in my kitchen. But veterinarians, we love animals. We love animals, you know? So I got to bring up my man Yoda. This is Yoda. As you get older, it's really true that you start to look like your pet. Because this morning, my neighbor came over and yelled at me for shitting in his front yard. Yoda's 16. I finally taught him how to be housebroken. I finally housebroke him. He poops on the floor, and then I'd rub his nose in it and throw him out the window. Now when he poops on the floor, he rubs his own nose in it and jumps out the window. It's a new joke. You know, being a veterinarian, people ask me all the time about North Korea. Where were the North Koreans when they made the third Hangover movie? Jesus, that piece of shit, you know? And my New England Journal of Medicine just came out, and it said that the North Koreans, on average, have the tiniest penises of any group on the planet. That's just in this world. So check, please. No wonder they're so angry. But as veterinarians, we're also known as great dancers. And, you know, I turned 60 a few years ago. And so I always wanted to learn how to dance, right? Who didn't? You know, and so singing in the rain and tap dancing, all the wonderful dancers. You like tap dance? Yeah. I like tap dance too. So I joined a group at the Whirling, at a Cherry Creek dance called the Whirling Dervishes. I was the oldest. I was 60, and the second oldest was 8. There were 2 5-year-olds and 1 6-year-old. He got a lot of the solos, but that's another story. But tonight, I've practiced a special holiday dance for you. Do you enjoy tap dance? You do, huh? Yeah. Tap dance is a young man's game. I got about a year left. Now, I can get away with this because I got good features. Oh, that's rich. And I gotta sit over here so I don't give you a free shot.
Put my shoes on. And then a wonderful holiday dance. Note to myself, next time put the potato in the front.
Give it up one more time for Dr. Kevin Fitzgerald, you guys. And Yoda. Yeah. And Andy Selm. All right. This is going to sound kind of stupid, but we have to do this, you guys. If you're on the side of veterinarians, let's hear it for Andy Selm, everybody. Veterans, excuse me. Doesn't matter. Your winner, Dr. Kevin Fitzgerald, everybody, on the side of veterans.